What's going on everybody, this is Kurt and welcome to a new compelling video. I just started my journey here, so for the newcomers, Primal VFX is the place where we'll learn about CG, visual effects and much more. And today we will discover how to make next level urban decals for Substance Painter inside Photoshop. Yeah, the OG Photoshop. Grab your attention, right? So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea and let's roll the intro.
So guys, today we will see how to make a kind of stencil spray paint effect inside Photoshop to really push to a next level your urban decals. So I have something in mind. I really like Banksy. You know Banksy, the famous England-based street artist. So as you can see, he's got a really particular style. Also, satirical and subversive message is really important in its creations. So first off, we need a good design. At least, I will try to. Let's make it together. We will need a good font. So a really famous website for searching free font is dafont.com. We've got a lot of different categories. Let's go in script and unwritten category. Let's see if we can find something interesting. Nothing that grabbed really my attention. Another website for searching fonts is dailyfont.com. Discovered it quite recently. It offers some quite interesting fonts. The websites also have font categories. Let's select stencil. Let's see if we can find something interesting. This one is particularly spot on. Yeah, it will do it. Let's download it. Okay, now for the artwork that I have in mind. I need an illustration with woman eyes. Let's search it. Okay, this one is really good. Let me save it for later. Okay, let's create the artwork inside Adobe Illustrator first. Let's grab a new document and make a 4K canvas. So 49.6 by 49.6 pixels. Boom. Okay. Let's write something a bit interesting. Now we can select the text and change the font to our previously downloaded one, Skate Brand. I'm adjusting a bit the kerning of the text. It's the spacing between individual letters or character. Okay, then let's make the text layout more appealing. Okay. Good. Let's convert the text to vectorial. Now, I will show you a cool trick. Let's grab the eyes image. So to convert it into vectorial shape, just click Image Trace, then Expand. Boom, done. Isn't it magic? Now, let's ungroup it and release the compound mask. Need to clean a bit the artwork. Now, I want to detach this part of the artwork. Let's take the eraser really quick. Okay, now let's put it in place and make few adjustments. It's all about design and feeling it right. Boom, really like it. Now let's put some colors. Really quick, I will choose two colors. I want everything blue apart from the tears and the bottom text. Okay, we are done with the artwork. What do you think about it? Pretty neat, right? Okay, now we are in Adobe Photoshop to add an extra layer of awesomeness. So first, let's create a new document and make a 4K canvas. So 49.6 by 49.6 pixels. Let's create the background black. So Ctrl plus I on the keyboard, then Ctrl plus V for paste our illustration from Illustrator. Select Smart Object. Like this, we can scale it without losing details. Now we can duplicate it to keep a copy of it. Like this, just in case, we will have a backup, because the next steps are a destructive workflow. So right click to rasterize it. It means it's now pixelized and it's no more a vectorial embedded file. Let's make it white. So Ctrl plus L to bring up the levels control window. Now I make a mask. So click on this icon. Then enter in the mask, so Alt plus click on the mask. Now we want to create a turbulent noise, so go to the menu, filter, render and clouds. Ctrl plus L for bringing up the levels control window once again. And we need to crush a bit the blacks and whites to make it more contrasted. Okay. Get back on the main layer and right click to disable the mask. We don't want it as a mask really, but it will serve as an FX mask. So now the most important step, go to Menu, Filter, Blur, then Lens Blur. We will use our generated turbulent noise as a depth map. So in Source, select Layer Mask, Crank up the radius effect to the max, 100. You can change the shape of the iris to heptagon to make it more particular. Press OK now. So lens blur is quite a heavy Photoshop effect, so be a bit patient. Nice, we begin to have something. Then, before you do anything, really important, go to Menu, Edit, then click on Fade Lens Blur. Really important to do it right now, because you can do it after any other manipulations. As you can see, manipulating with the slider, you can make the original layer with the Lens Blur FX1. So let's bring back a bit the original below, like 80%, it will be fine. Okay. We are getting there, but not quite. Now we can delete the mask, create a new layer and fill it with black. Shift plus F5. Then click on the main layer and press Ctrl plus E to collapse and flatten the two layers together. Now, another important step. As the next FX needs transparency to work correctly, let's copy the artwork into a mask. So create a mask and copy, select the mask and then paste the artwork into the mask. Back to the layer, let's fill it with white. So Shift plus F5, select white, then hit OK. Now the real trick here, where everything takes final form. Let's switch the transfer mode of the layer to dissolve. Boom, that's a real trick. We can also tweak a bit the FX with the opacity. Bring it lower, it will reveal more dots in the non-transparent areas. So like this, as you can see, you can adjust as you want the FX. So let's put a value like 95% just to bring back a bit more dots. Then we can collapse the layers together. Again, Ctrl plus E. So it's looking really nice, but let's blur it just a bit. So go to Menu, Filter, Blur and Gaussian Blur. Let's put a small value here, like 0.3. Really looking great. What do you think?
Hey you, I know you're watching my video and I know you're not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button.
Now let's bring up extra layers of details. I'm adding some paint, dirt, drips and splatters. It's all based on feelings and getting happy of the final result. Now let's make a colored version of it. I will not enter in every step here, it's kind of a repetitive process, but basically I've just made a mask of the artwork and below it I'm creating the layers of colors. Done. Let's export them into PNGs for Substance Painter. Okay, let's check now inside Substance Painter if everything works fine. I'm opening a test scene that I've made really quickly, adding the two decals in the shelf with import resources. Be careful to select alpha for the mask and texture for the colored one. After entering a keyword to find them easily, press OK. Let's take the paintbrush, switch off everything apart color, input the mask decal into alpha and stamp it onto the geo. Boom. Also, we can try the color version. Just drop the color decal into base color input. Really, really nice. What do you think? This is a really cool way of doing stencil decals. By the way, if you are interested in some really cool decals, on my Gumroad store, you've got two pretty bundles available. If you are curious about it, the link is in the description.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.